Good afternoon. Today we will enter into unit 3rd of law and social transformation. Unit 3rd is related to the rights of children. In a society where the human being have the nature to control and to rule over the weaker persons, and in the system of the society there is another moral, religious, spiritual, social good behavior system of the society, which says that all have the equal status, dignity, and opportunity of development. Therefore, for the purpose of the concept of natural feeling of the human being for welfare of the everyone, I would like to quote here one quotation which is written under the Taittiriya Upanishad. It says that सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राण पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्। Everyone have the right of happiness. Everyone to live without any kind of the ill health. Everyone to live in a society that others shall treat to him equally. No person should be in any kind of problem. This is the spirit of ideal, religious, spiritual, moral, and good behavior of the society. In this system where everyone wants to live with dignified life and to get every kind of opportunity for the development of person. Then after this idea of well-being in the society, it requires to be think over the some special kind of attention to those persons who have physically not equal to the others. If we are talking about the persons or some human beings who are existing in the society have no equal physical existence as others have. Under this category of not having the equal physical existence, children comes in the first place. And children of the society deserves to get every kinds of rights and greater rights rather than the rights of physically strong person. Therefore, the today's concept is related to the jurisprudential and philosophical aspect of the rights of children in a global society, in an international society. Before entering into that part, it requires to highlight the syllabus which is prescribed for the LLM student by the Kumau University. Under this third unit, you have the syllabus. The one of the component of the syllabus is child labor, prohibition of and regulation of child labor in India. Second is the protection from the sexual harassment or exploitation. And the third is the adoption and related problems. And fourth component of the syllabus under unit third is the children's education. The subject matter of social transformation is the ideology, jurisprudential philosophy, global scenario, legal system at international level, and then naturally the Indian system. Under this first aspect of philosophical background of the rights of children, okay, in the society, every human being's habit and attitude, nature is not equal. Some person's habit is self-centered, only to think over the own interest, and some human being's habit is only to get more and more, and some habits is of only to protect own life and life of the members of own relatives and family. Therefore, because of this social habit of human being, it requires to make the proper law. And that proper law's object should be to provide and to facilitate everyone the equal status, including the status and protection of the rights of the children. And if we will go into the discussion and analysis of the ideology of the every person, and a famous poet, Milton, has said about the rights of the children that they have more claim over the human being, because if we will protect, we will preserve, and we will nurture the today child, and that will be the indication of the future society. If a strong child will be there for the purpose of mental strongness, educational strongness, physical strongness, social strongness, dignity in the society, the future society will be the same. Every kind of strongness will be there. This is the observation of the one of the poets, Milton, for the protection and promotion of the rights of the children and to provide every kind of facility to them. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, known as the Chacha Nehru, and his birthday is being celebrated as the Child Day in India. And he said about the rights of children that our duty is to preserve, nurture, protect, and provide the more facility to the children rather than the facility and other necessities to the human being who is physically complete. And he said that today children are the future of tomorrow's nation. In the same way, our popular Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji also started various schemes for the protection and giving the sufficient rights to the children, and said that Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Other schemes are there to protect the rights of the children in India. And the Supreme Court of India, in various cases, expressed the special kind of jurisprudential observation. And that jurisprudential observation says that if we will spend much money on the children, then certainly we will get the more resources in future. A famous case in this regard of philosophical and jurisprudential aspect is the Rohit Singhal versus Principal Jawaharlal Nehru Vidyalaya. It is a case of 2009. The Justice R.C. Lohati has expressed a very sensitive type of observation in the interest of the children. That child or children are not only the citizen of future, but they are the future of the country. Children are not only the future of the particular society, but they are the future of, strong future of the nation. Their probability and well-being cannot be confined only on the citizen of future, but they have the more powerfulness, strongness, and special kind of capacity to make the nation strong and strongest. Therefore, this philosophical aspect reflects that the children have more claim or a powerful claim, a legitimate claim over the society. Because if they will become strong for all the purpose, naturally the society will also become the strong. Then what are the areas after this philosophical aspect of the law? There are another area, and these areas are the international system of law, international efforts to protect the rights of children, and the national efforts for the protection of the children. In an international background, we can see this efforts had made by the international political organization from very beginning, from the beginning of 19th century. That was the year of 1924, when there was the League of Nations into the existence. After the First World War, League of Nations established at the international level to protect the rights of human beings. And due to the efforts of League of Nations, in the year 1924, a declaration was issued by the League of Nations. Declaration, international declaration. And that is called Geneva Declaration. By this declaration, the rights has recognized by the international political organization of the children. And these rights were right to food, right to protection from the disease, because the children's physical capacity is not to resist like the strong capacity, physical capacity of a adult. Therefore, in that declaration, Geneva Declaration, there was one right: protection from the disease, a ill health should be protected, or even if shall be protected by the state member. Then right to shelter, because there is a population of children who have no shelter. In 1924, there was the condition to sleep at night without having the shelter. This right was recognized. Who will provide, whose duty is there to provide the right to health, shelter, food, and safety? That is the right of, that is the rights of children, but vice versa, the duty of state. And therefore, this Geneva Convention expressed the views or the principles of the strongness of declaration, principles of strongness of the children by a declaration. Though according to the international law, declaration have no same authority as the authority is under the convention and covenant. But once the declaration shall be adopted by the member state, then certainly the duty lies according to the constitutional system of a particular country. Even if, as in my earlier lectures, I have highlighted Article 253 of the Constitution, there is a duty to enforce the declaration. That was the 1924. And in that year, it had laid down the certain rights of the people. But as you know, very soon, there was the Second World War. And what were the reasons of the Second World War? The first reason was failure of League of Nations. Due to the failure of League of Nations, because League of Nations was not a powerful international organization to control the human behavior internationally, so that this should not be the war and like other inhuman activities in the world. And the Second World War was very serious and dangerous. And even if one can see the scenario of that time to attack on the Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and during the Second World War, children were also the victim of the scientific attack. They were also the victim. Therefore, after the end of the Second World War, internationally, it was the duty of the some powerful countries to come on the single platform. And you might be known that in 1941, in the month of August. There was a charter which is known as Atlantica Charter. Because of the efforts of Roosevelt and Churchill, a document prepared for the future peace and tranquility and protection of human rights, freedoms, and other kinds of the rights of human being, they have entered into a agreement. Later on, that document has signed by other states. 28 states signed that document, and then San Francisco conference was there, and ultimately United Nations established for the functioning of peace and promotion of the rights of every human being. Then I have said that the one of the document at the international level came into existence, that was the UDHR, Universal Declaration of Human Rights, 1948, and came enforced or adopted by the General Assembly of United Nations on the 10th December 1948. And some provisions of this declaration I have also referred at the time of the rights of women in India with reference to the subject matter of social transformation. But some other rights which are related to the children are also very essential to point out, to discuss and analyze for the purpose of the protection of rights of children, UDHR. There is a special article, Article 25. As I have said that there are 30 articles, 29, 30 and is related to the duty. 25 says that as it has stated in the Geneva Convention of 1924, the Declaration of the Rights of Children, the same right is given under Article 25, that is the right to food, right to shelter, right to the development, and so on. Though this right as enshrined under Article 25 of the UDHR is for all, irrespective of any kind of age. This is for all. And when we are talking about for all, it includes the children. Then a special right is given by the International Declaration, that is the Universal Declaration of the Human Rights, That is Article 26. And Article 26 is related to the right to education of children. But before this right to education of children, the another part of 25 is also there, which says that motherhood, 25 clause 2 says that motherhood should be protected. And at the same time, children are deserve for the special care. Mother should be protected. Rights of the motherhood should be strongly protected. And the children's deserve to or deserve for the special care. 25 clause. If the motherhood shall be protected or motherhood shall be especially given the attention, then the protection and the promotion of rights of mother is for children also. Because if we will compare this provision of Article 25 clause 2 with the Indian system, there are rules for the preserving the health and protecting the health of motherhood in India at present, which are being providing the facility through the Anganwadi and the Asha Karyakarti, they are there working under the some rules. But one of the very powerful provision is under the Criminal Procedure Code. Motherhood should be protected. 25 clause 2 of the UDHR. There is one provision under section 416 that if any woman got the capital punishment by committing the crime and convicted by the competent court, if she is pregnant, the punishment cannot be executed. And now amendment has been made and the discretion was given to the court, and that capital punishment can be converted into life imprisonment. Because of the care of child. It means 25 clause 2 UDHR, which says that the protection should be given to the motherhood, indirectly includes the safety of child. In the same way, as I have pointed out that there is the right to education under the UDHR. Of course, in India, right to education recognized by Indian competent legislature by 86th amendment of the Constitution. But this was the right at the international level from the year 1948, which had prescribed under this Article 26 of the UDHR, it has said that the primary education shall be free. UDHR says that the primary education shall be free at international level. And when Indian Constitution came into force in India under Article 45, this was in the form of direction as a policy for the state. But in UDHR, it was from very beginning, from the year 1948. This is one of the assessment of the free education to the children up to the primary level, that is up to the year of 14 years. And apart from this primary education, there is a still question that whether after getting only primary education, the students or the children are competent to earn the livelihood, or they are strong enough to understand the situation for the betterment of the society. Third question, only the primary education is sufficient? The various questions are, the answer of these questions partly given by the Article